China rose plant is a group of pretty roses flowering with constant regularity throughout the season, forming twiggy bushes with a smaller and more dainty foliage than modern roses. Hibiscus care is easy. If you learn these few simple tips, you could enjoy blooms throughout the year. People usually complain their hibiscus plant doesn't bloom or produces no flower at all in spite of providing proper conditions. The main reason for this is a pot size. Actually, hibiscus loves to be root bound and produces maximum flowers when it is root bound. So select a pot which is slightly bigger than a root ball. Soil for hibiscus should be well drained, light, and the one that retains moisture. Hibiscus is actually an acid loving plant and happily grows in soil with pH 6 to 7. So for the perfect soil mix, take 30% soil, 20% sand, 20% cocoa peat, 20% cow dung compost, and 10% vermicompost. In addition, make top layer soil with a mixture of cow dung compost and vermicompost. Compost is actually acidic in nature and also helps in retaining moisture. Cocoa peat also helps in retaining moisture as well as provides good drainage. Sand makes the soil porous. After potting your plant in a perfect size pot and perfect soil, the second very important tip is its location. Hibiscus loves to grow in a bright indirect sunlight. If you provide good light, China rose will produce its maximum flowers because birds need good sunlight to bloom well. Place the pot in a sunny location isn't just sufficient, but monitor temperature is much more important than it. Ideal temperature for hibiscus is 16 to 32 degrees Celsius. If temperature are below 10 degrees Celsius, most growth and blooming will stop and flower size will be smaller and deformed. A freeze will cause the plant to die, so be sure to move your plant indoors before the first frost. Hibiscus requires frequent or regular watering because it grows well in root-bound conditions. If your hibiscus blooms well, then its water need will be high. Before you water, just stick your finger into the soil about 1 inch to 2 inches. If the soil is dry or just slightly moist, it's time to water. Hibiscus prefer to remain moist but not wet, and they don't like to dry out too much in between waterings. Fertilizing plant is most important during the growing period. If you want to get maximum and healthy flowers on your plant, give it a good fertilizer weekly. You can give organic as well as chemical fertilizer to your plant. Actually, hibiscus needs NPK, having more potassium and less phosphorus. So for potassium rich organic fertilizer, there are two best fertilizers. Number one is banana peel powder. Give it 2 teaspoons weekly. Number 2 is used and dried tea leaves. Give it 2 teaspoons weekly. Banana liquid fertilizer also gives good result. But never use bone meal, DAP and phosphate because they contain phosphorus in rich amount, which hibiscus don't need. You can also apply chemical fertilizer, but never forget to water your plant before and after fertilizing because due to salt accumulation, roots and leaves can be burned. Two fertilizers are best. Number one, potash or potassium sulfate. Dilute 1 teaspoon in a liter water and spray all over the plant. Number two is Epsom salt, magnesium sulfate. Dilute in water but apply monthly to keep your leaves green. Chemical fertilizer should be given monthly. During winter, plant don't need fertilizer as it goes in dormancy period. To sustain a healthy plant, the soil should be kept uniformly moist. In hot sunny weather, this will require watering every day. Misting of the leaves with the help of a spray bottle adds welcome humidity as well as a cleansing of the leaf surface that requires for healthy breathing. Propagation in hibiscus takes place through cuttings. Take a cutting of 4 to 6 inches long. Dip the bottom of the hibiscus cutting in rooting hormone. The next step is to place it in well-draining soil. Make sure the rooting soil is thoroughly wet. Determine if the hibiscus truly needs repotting by checking the drain hose of its present container for protruding roots. Then it's time to repotting. Repotting should be done in spring. To boost flower bearing, remove wilted flowers regularly, which is called deadheading. Once the blossom get dried, prune 1/3 of the branch so that growth will be maximized. Pruning should be done during growing phase when it's blooming. Hibiscus usually faces two types of problems. Number one is pest attack. Number two is leaf yellowing. Hibiscus commonly attacked by mealybugs. Simply spray neem oil spray regularly as a preventive measure. If neem oil is not available, you can use soap water spray in diluted form or garlic water spray in diluted form. To learn step-by-step method to remove mealybugs from your plant by applying organic recipe, you can watch my video. Link is given in the description box. Causes of leaf yellowing is many, such as nutrient deficiency, overwatering, underwatering, increase or decrease from required temperature, cool or hot air effect, increase or decrease from required sunlight, pest attack, changes in the location of pot. So observe these changes in order to stop leaf yellowing in hibiscus. I have given you complete information regarding growing healthy hibiscus. If you apply these simple tips, you could be enjoy healthy blooms throughout the year. I grow hibiscus because it blooms almost whole year. Why do you like to grow? Please write me in the comment box below.